Hello everybody, my name is Christina Reich. I am product manager for Universal Reporter and I will give you today in the second session an update on Universal Reporter. We are going to cover the following topics. First, I'm going to speak about existing functionality, like for instance, the generic function which allows you to create reports. Then I'm going to talk about the possibilities to find objects on the PID. The next chapter will be about finding duplicate items, for instance duplicate valves or duplicate pipe runs which have the same tag. And then we will cover the topic data editing in the interface of Universal Reporter directly, but also how to use import from Excel to update data for PID for 3D and then write it back to the original application. From the point of view of new functionality, it is going to be a little bit more PID specific. We have added a possibility to extract drawing revision metadata from the database, and also some additional drawing attributes, which I will show you. And in the next little chapter, I will show you how you can create a difference list between two PID revisions, which means this is the first time that in the PID area, we are able to extract frozen data and not the actual current data from the database. In the first part, I'm going to start the live demonstration in a few moments with the reporting function. And as you can see, for all the different tables that are available from the applications, we can generate reports. And then what you have displayed in the grid of Universal Reporter can be exported to Excel. And of course, the Excel templates give you also the possibility to make a better formatting, adding a logo, giving the report a title, using, for instance, the plant name, and so on. In terms of zooming objects on the PID, all the objects that are listed in the different tables in the interface of Universal Reporter, like pumps, like vessels, like pipe runs, they can be visualized in graphic, and then the content can eventually also be saved to a PDF file. So this means that you can really also generate next to the reports also the graphical information and have it available. In the chapter about finding the duplicate items, I'm going to show two examples. The first example will allow you to find duplicate valves and eventually also display them on the PID so that they can be changed and modified. And another topic which is quite important is that in the PIDs, it's not so easy to identify if you have duplicate item tags which are graphically not connected. And this is why we have introduced an attribute called NotConnectedRun. And this attribute, if it displays a value which is different than zero, means that this pipe run has some graphical connectivity problem. And here in this example, you can see that the little branch has the same number like this one. And this is again a situation which needs to be modified. When we talk about data editing, then what we mean is that the snapshot, which is created by the report adapters, for instance for PID or for SmartPlant 3D, can be modified. If the user makes modifications, then automatically an old value of the attribute is displayed so that he or she knows this is my change and this is what is in the snapshot. And from this place, you can still go back and revert to the snapshot. And if you want to write the changes to the database, there are commands available which are using the authoring applications APIs to write these modifications into the database. Besides the manual editing possibility, you can also use Excel files, make changes in the Excel files, and then import the changes into the interface of Universal Reporter. This is a method that we highly recommend and which is used by a lot of our clients, so that you don't have to use the manual modifications. You can do it directly importing from Excel. Okay, now we are coming to the first part of the live demonstration, and I want first to show you the interface which we are using to create the PID snapshot. So the tool is called PID Report Adapter, and you have the possibility to select the dataset, which means either a complete plant or selected drawings. And for these drawings, you can extract a configuration of attributes with some additional parameters, and in the end, they will go into a snapshot, which we then are opening with Universal Reporter. What is really new about this interface, and I will come back to it later, is the possibility to also access frozen data. So this one will allow you to extract revisions, while the other ones will always extract live data. Now, when we have a look at this data in Universal Reporter, we can easily recognize that you can see the application where the data comes from. So this is a snapshot from PID. It has different tables, so you can just switch between the different tables and see the corresponding information. And from each of these tables, you have the possibility to export data to Excel, either just by saying that you want a plain and simple report. In this case, you will just get a copy of the content into an Excel file, yeah, like you see here. But you can also choose a template which was created for this view, and eventually you can even choose to add the code lists. So we are going to do this, and in this case you will get a report which has a much nicer formatting and which also has the select list values copied into the report, so that if you want to change material of construction, which is a select list in PID, you can click on this list and just choose a value from the list. As you see, you can add logos, you can add titles, you can add some additional fields like the plant name, and this is the result that you can generate with Universal Reporter. I have also prepared something for a 3D dataset. So I'm going to open this 3D dataset now. And as you see, again, here we also have equipment and pipe run information. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to select some pipe runs. So I can use, for instance, a filter by list and just click on them and use them as a little filter. And now I'm going to create a report which creates a piping MTO per line. I'm going to use this template. And this report now is formatted in such a way that it collects the inline components for every pipeline and displays them in the end in the report together with the rest of the data coming from the selection that we have done for the 3D piping table. Yeah, so you see it's a piping material takeoff. It is running through the single pipeline systems, and for each it looks at commodity types and also sizes and so on, and then it is calculating the quantity of the material. And as you can see here, for the pipe runs, the quantity would be the length, which is displayed in millimeter, but if you have single components, you can see that they are counted as pieces. And it is a quite nice method to be able to create these types of reports also for data coming from 3D. So much to the reporting. I will now go on with the highlight function. which means I'm going to show you that for PID data, you can just select an object, you can click on right mouse highlight, and then the object will be searched and displayed in Smart Sketch. This is not only valid for equipment, also if we go to the pipe run area, we can have a look where is this large nominal diameter, how does this look like. So I'm going to highlight this one as well. And as you see, this is a pipe run with the size that we have been looking for. And as I already mentioned, it is also possible to save these files as PDF. And because this is not a highlight, we really are putting a color on the elements. You can very easily create color-coded PDFs just searching for some objects or even for complete, let's say, fluid systems and things like that. Okay. The next chapter will be to find the duplicate items. As discussed, we will first look for duplicate inline components, which can be valves or control valves. So this is a list of PID inline components with the associated drawing. And if we add, for instance, the inline component as PID, we can see that there are some that might have like the same item tag, but it's not so easy to recognize. So therefore, there is a generic count function which very easily gives us the information that this valve in this drawing is placed 2 times. Even if I take the drawing away, I get the same information. And now, when I have this information, again, I can use the highlight function to find the valves and to see in which drawing they are and at which position and so on. And I can give this to somebody who can make the corresponding modifications. So, as I said, this is the generic count function, which allows me to search for all kinds of duplicates, not only valve names. Coming to the duplicate runs, we have introduced a special attribute in the extraction from the PID, in the extraction process. The attribute is called not connected runs. And with this attribute, whenever you encounter something that is not zero, means that there is a connectivity problem for the pipe runs. So in my case, I have a pipe run with this name. It is located in this PID and something is not right. So I'm just going to open the drawing, have a look at the result. And here I think it's very obvious to see that this little branch has the same number like this pipe, but it's not really connected to it. It's connected to the other one. And this is a situation that is not so easy to discover, so I really placed these labels on purpose so that it's visible, but in reality you can have this type of problem in lots of PIDs and you will not see the label on the little pipe. So our tool is calculating this information and will give you the result in a report, but also the possibility to view it in graphic. In the next chapter, we are going to have a look at the data editing functions. We are coming back to the equipment area, and we are going to start with manual changes. So if I want to rename something like, I don't know, cooler into 123 or whatever, I can type it directly in these white fields. The gray fields, they are read-only fields. And if I click on another field, then I get my change marked in blue. And automatically I get an old value column, which will show the value that exists in the snapshot. If the field has a select list, I can use the values from the select list to change, to make changes. And again, I will get this old value so that I can watch it. And as I already mentioned, it is always possible to reset either the single values, but I could also reset the complete column, or eventually, if I make an import from Excel, I could reset the complete table. So this is the procedure how you can make manual changes. A nice method is also that you have the possibility to replace data. So if I would decide that I want to replace drum with vessel, I can use the replace function, and then in all the places where it finds the word drum, it will replace it with vessel, and there's even a more sophisticated method so that you can replace only first or last part of a string and so on, but we are not going to do that. So I will reset the table, and now I will switch to the next possibility, which means that I'm going to create an Excel list with select lists. I will save it. And in the report that is created right now, I will make some modifications and then import it back into the interface. I also want to mention that besides the reports that we create directly from this interface, it is also possible to take foreign reports and import them back in. The procedure is always the same. I can go to Tools Import from Excel. I select the report, and with the Next button, I need to make the choice which attribute do I want to use as a key column, and which attributes do I want to update. In my case, it's just these two, but of course I could add all of the attributes that are displayed here. And then I can import the data, and the modifications are visible exactly in the same way like if I would make manual modifications. If I really want to write this to the PID database, I can use the command write changes to SmartPlan PID, and this command will trigger the API. It will work based on SPIDs and not necessarily on the item tag, which means if you want to modify pressure temperature for a pipe run, which crosses across three or four drawings, it will automatically modify all the pipe runs that are like hidden behind this line in Universal Reporter. And then you will have to eventually run update drawing so that the labels get updated and so on. And this is the way how these modifications occur. Exactly in the same way, you can also do the changes for SmartPlant 3D and write them back with the 3D API to the 3D database. Okay, we are going to go back to the slide. So the next thing I want to talk about is the revision issue. So we now have the possibility to extract revision metadata, which means number, description, and so on, and also if there is a version associated to the revision, which is a quite important information because the version contains the snapshot and the data and not so much the revision number. And for PIDs, we have been asked to also try to find out if drawings do have, for instance, an auxiliary graphic placed, and also how many versions exists for a drawing. So this is what we did in this area, and I will show you this just in a few seconds. Concerning the data associated with the revisions, which is stored in the PID database as frozen data, we implemented the extra option in PID report adapter, which looks at the revisions. And this option finds first, last, these other two, but also static revision numbers, if you like. So this means that if the drawings have different revision numbers, let's say the last revision can be A for one drawing, but maybe E for another drawing, you can use this method to extract. But if you have the situation where all the drawings have revision B and maybe other drawings have E, you can also use the snapshots with this method. Once the data is extracted and you have the two snapshots, what you can do is use them for comparison in Universal Reporter, and you will get a difference list. This little example shows equipment comparison between two revisions which were extracted from the PID, and you will find different objects, which means they exist in both databases, but in this case the item tag was renamed. In this case, some technical data has been modified, but you can only see what is only on one side or what is only on the other side. And a new function that we introduced is the possibility to start the highlight directly from the multi-window or from the comparison window, which means you can just click right mouse highlight and then both PIDs will open and you will see the data that you are looking for. Okay, now let's see how does this look like. The metadata for the revisions is something that you will find in the attribute configuration. The attribute configuration is the part where you tell the software which attributes to extract when the snapshot is created. And for the drawings, you see that we have introduced the new revision table where you can just check this major, minor revision number and so on. But we have also added the version associated field, which allows you to see if there is a real, let's say, blob in the database containing the data. And in addition, we have also created these two new attributes. One is called number of auxiliary graphic and the other number of versions, which help you identify the quality of the PIDs in terms of these two topics that you see here. When it comes to extracting revision data, then you need to use this button down here. And this button gives you the possibility to select the first revision, the last revision, which is kind of the newest. And if you see, if I use this choice, then I get another value for some drawings than I get, for instance, for these drawings. But I can also work with static queries, like I want to extract only revision E, and then this interface will only display the drawings that really do have revision E stored in the database. Okay, let's go back to Universal Reporter and see how this data looks like for the revisions. First of all, the drawing revision data is available here so that you can create a report. You see a list of PIDs with different revisions. You see if each of those revisions has a version associated or not. And then you have also additional metadata like descriptions and so on. This special attribute which we are calculating is just putting the last revision on the drawing level so that you can get one report where you always see which is the last revision for each drawing, which is eventually the first revision, and even this last minus one and last minus two. The other topic with the additional drawing attributes is shown in this little example. You have again the list of drawings. You can see for each of them if they contain auxiliary graphic or not, and also how many versions exist in the database for these drawings so that you can make your decision if you want to clean up some versions based on the number that you see. Okay, I'm going to close this dataset now. And in the last example, which I want to show, I will make the comparison between the revisions. And for this, I'm going to use the recent function, which will extract the RevC snapshot. And in the next step, I'm going to open the RevE snapshot so that I have them both. And if I have two of these snapshots, I can use these windows to arrange them. So for instance, like this, I can put them one on top of the other. And for the comparison, I just want you to understand that all the fields that are visible in the original windows will automatically run into the comparison process. So I am going to show this with, let's say, 5 or 6 attributes, but if you have 20 or 30, it will work exactly the same. So I'm going to drag the table and drop it. I'm going to rename the Monica so that it's easier to see what is E and what is C, but I don't really have to do this. I'm going to choose the SPID for linking the revisions together, and I'm going to decide that I want to see the complete data set. So now I get a window which displays the complete content of both data sets from E and from C. And if I like, I can put together the attributes that have the same name so that it's easier to recognize the values and so on. And from here, I can start the comparison either with only differences or with displaying everything from the original view. If I want to see only the differences, I end up with this is what we call the difference list. There is a special field called master tag generated dynamically, and this will tell you if you have objects on both sides with changes in the values or if you have objects which are available only on one side. From here, as I said, it is possible now to open and highlight the objects. And if I want, for instance, to see where are these two new pumps here, I can select the rows and use the highlight just within the drawing where they exist, of course. And I can create a report with or without template using the export grid with color so that in the end I have this difference list, which in my case comes from the comparison of two revisions, but it could also be last revision versus actual data or whatever, one project against another project and so on. Okay, I'm done with the live presentation, so I will switch back to the slides. Just to say thank you for the interest and for listening.